Our presentation entitled Conservation Agriculture Adapting Cropping Systems in Dryland Areas to Climate Change Challenge have been prepared by colleagues from CIRAD. We'll focus on dryland area specific constraints according to CA principles. And just to talk about CA principles, for us the most important thing is just to mention that three different principles are important in CA, and each principle will have its importance in dryland areas, mostly concerning carbon sequestration and water management. The principles are those that Friedrich have just cited. I mean, minimum soil disturbance, permanent soil cover, and diversified crop rotation and association. Talking about dryland areas, the main characteristics of dryland areas are short single mode rainfall, excluding various agronomic possibilities. We are not in a humid environment, therefore we have just one single mode rainfall. We have also fragile natural ecosystem due to extremely constrained climatic conditions. And also, though the single mode rainfall, there is a contradiction because there's a high competition on space and biomass in dryland areas, and a high competition between farmers and herders on crop residues. And there are also frequent bushfires on crop residues and natural vegetation due also to extreme weather conditions and also to farmers' practices. At last, we can talk about small-scale agriculture due to high population density in dryland areas. So we have decided to divide into two different issues, climate challenges in dryland areas. We may talk sometimes about climate change determinants, carbon emission increased by fossil energy uses, and also natural potential of carbon sequestration due to CA. In one hand, and in other hand, we will be talking about climate change effects. That is, how CA can act on the consequences of climate change, such as climatic conditions variation, actual natural ecosystem troubling by runoff and erosion, and all those things. To talk about CA potential on determinants, I mean, on factors influencing climate change in dryland areas, there are specifically 3 points. The first one will be energy savings due to absence of soil tillage, because we use less weeding operations and fertilization operations and other technical operations. It results in energy savings, but also with CA we will be reducing carbon emission due to photosynthesis and increase by crop photosynthesis increased by crop rotation and association. The third point will be the fact that no-till farming and organic matter management in CA increases soil organic carbon sequestration. Climate change determinants may be buffered by CA in different ways. First, soil permanent cover and high biological activities related may improve soil buffer power in water management, and we'll show it. And also, soil permanent cover may reduce soil temperature variation. That is, in dryland areas, other than having extreme weather variation due to soil permanent cover, the typical soil temperature variation will not be as much as it should if there has not been the soil cover. And also CA may reduce runoff and soil erosion. And also CA-based technology may increase specific plant resistance and therefore improve its ability to resist all the different climatic variations. These pictures to show out that in dryland areas, due to specific soil structure and texture, it is common that any extreme rainfall results in frequent flooding when the slope is weak. That is, when the slope is not weak, you will have runoff or erosion, but when the slope is weak, it will result in flood in dryland areas. This is typically the kind of contradiction in dryland areas. And what we'll do in the next slide is just to focus on how water efficiency is organized with CA. Let us just talk about water balance determinants with soil cover. With soil cover, water balance consists of infiltration, and infiltration will be divided into deep drainage, plant use water, and also evaporation. In the other hand, the water provided by rainfall, which may be infiltrated, if not infiltrated, that it will be loose due to runoff or erosion or due to evaporation. Just to say that in CA cropping system, the main issue will be to diminish the loss and increase conservation of water for the use of the plant. This will be the specific aim of CA cropping system according to water management. Just these small trials to show out how infiltration may be influenced by CA. It's a very simple trials made up of 10 centimeter high head, fill of water, and what is being measured here is just the time around which the water inside this pool will completely infiltrate in the soil. Measurements have been made on conventional tillage plot, and we assessed that it took 1 hour and 30 minutes for the small spool to completely infiltrate the water in it, while it only took 7 minutes for CA, for the water to completely infiltrate in a CA plot. How is runoff or erosion reduced due to mulch? First, there is soil protection against splash effects of rainfall. Particles of soil are protected against splash effects and are also protected against transportation because of the soil keeping through densified root system. And this densified root system is due to the crop rotation and association. The next picture here shows that when we show the picture of the float, which is due to extra waters, to extra rainfalls, and a wake slope. When the slope is not wake, I mean, when water can be transported from up points to down points, then we will have this runoff and erosion. And water and the same Boli-Babule PhD thesis has measured the quantity of soil loss according to different soil management. And this in northern Cameroon, it has been established that with conventional tillage, 26 tons per hectare and per year soil is lost, has been lost every year, while 7 tons per hectare of soil is still being lost even with these anti-erosion structures. Here here we use grass contour, and we still lose 7 tons per hectare, while with CA the loss is only 2 tons per hectare, showing out that whatever the case, soil will lose soil, and it is important that this soil loss is being reduced by soil management. How is it possible that crop residues on top of the soil can reduce runoff? It's very simple. We can see that on these two pictures, due to the small stems on the soil surface, water cannot easily move from one point to another, and the water will spend more time on the same surface, making it more possible for it to infiltrate. While if the soil is completely nude, then the water will circulate easily and will be lost for infiltration. And let's talk about carbon sequestration as the next challenge in the relation between CA and climate change. There are so many models on carbon dynamics, and we have chosen to illustrate our carbon dynamics according to the simple model of Helen Dupuy, which established that carbon balance is a relation between carbon input and carbon loss. E has been given as the annual additional rate of C. K1 is representing the coefficient, the humification coefficient. C is the soil organic carbon stock, and K2 is the annual oxidation rate. Just to make it clear that it's important that on a given plot, you could on one hand estimate what is the carbon inputs, and on the other hand estimate what is the total carbon loss every year, to at the end establish if you have the cropping systems were able to improve carbon sequestration. We'll do it more simply, but what we'll have to do first will be to show out this graph. This graph is making it clear that the principal challenge in dryland areas is how to fill the gap of dry season. The issue is how to fill the 8 months dry season with a crop which will be able to develop. The second issue is how to produce some more biomass only on 4 to 5 months to ensure the replacement of carbon loss each year. And the problem is not just that one, because it will be possible for us to do some crop association, as we said earlier, but sometimes it's not possible to practice crop association every year, because sometimes we'll have what we call on this graph commercial crop. It's not just, it's not real commercial crops, but it's it concerns crops like cowpea or cotton, which may not allow association, which may not also be able to produce sufficient biomass to replace total carbon loss on the plots. Let us do it. Let us see practically how this will be organized. This table to show how carbon sequestration will be organized in a two-year rotation, including the first year with cereal association with a cover crop, while the second year only cotton is being produced on the field. First remark is there is no dry season crop. This is a great difference with humid areas. That means there is no possibility for biomass production during the dry season. If you want to produce some biomass, then you will be forced to do it only on rainy seasons. And what we'll be doing here is just one season over two will produce biomass of cereals with a cover crop, and the second year will produce little biomass of cotton. We will have on the fifth line, on the fifth row, we will have the total dry matter produced, which will be 10 tons per hectare of biomass provided by sorghum and Bracharia association, and only the half of it, 5 tons per hectare of total biomass that is above ground and roots biomass produced by cotton. What will it give? That will give, these 10 tons per hectare will give a total carbon input of 1.01, while the 5 tons cotton dry matter will give only 0.53 total carbon input. Let us assess the carbon loss according to the fact that in the soil we have assessed 21.78 carbon stocks, and this stock will be mineralized at a rate K2, which will provide at the end a carbon loss of minus 0.63. Just for the first year, we will register 1.01 carbon input for minus 63 carbon lost. That will give us 0.38 ton per hectare of carbon balance for the first year. With cotton, we will notice that this carbon balance is negative and is for minus 0.11 tons per hectare, while the third year will have a 0.36 positive carbon balance, and also in for the fourth year a negative minus 0.13, for a total annual positive carbon balance of 0.13 tons per hectare, only provided by the extra biomass produced by the sorghum and Bracharia association. Just to make it clear that there are some crops, and so there will be some years that we will be losing some carbon from the soil, and there, so that it is very important for us to gain some carbon from other years. Carbon sequestration in dryland areas. To summarize, according to cropping systems, there are different ways to control input of dry matter. Principally, challenges on agronomic issues on biomass production. It's important that cover crops and crops have been screened in order to see which combination may ensure total biomass production with less effect on yield. And also, we must explore organic fertilizer application to respond to failure in credit and chemical input access. It is important that we focus on biomass production technologies according to agronomic issues of conservation agriculture in dry land areas. On the other hand, it is important to satisfy needs for biomass for other domestic use. It is also important to satisfy animal needs for biomass by valuing marginal spaces to produce forage. It will be also important to control bushfires and other source of loss in crop residues. This will make it absolutely important that we will need a consultative framework to preserve and to better manage biomass use, even if this biomass is being produced. The agronomic challenge will be to produce some more biomass, and the socioeconomic challenge will be to manage and to preserve part of this biomass that will be able to ensure positive carbon balance for the fields.